Bubble, we're already down 20 or so percent from the highs, but the technicals are suggesting that we could head down even lower into 13,000 and maybe even 10,000. Bitcoin has experienced 75% corrections on at least three occasions in its history, so it is very normal for it to have a little bit of a drop. And what I've found important with clients and with people in the market to separate is the price story from the long-term disruption opportunity with Bitcoin and blockchain in general. Price is extremely irrational, and now it is looking, if we continue lower, like this could be a broader contagion story for the other markets.
That's interesting that you say that, because I mean, Bitcoin is still controversial, and I would say that it's probably not widely owned across the populace, unlike property or technology stocks in previous crisis cycles. So why is Bitcoin the canary in the coal mine for risk for all asset classes at this point?
Well, it's the one that sucked up as much money so far, and it is the poster child for cryptos to date. In the end, what was interesting, the contrarian signal actually seemed to take place after the future market launch just recently, and that then led to the failed move and a reversal thereafter. So that could be one to look back in hindsight.
Ron, sorry, I don't understand how you can portray anything from the chart so far apart from violence. Absolute violence still to come on this asset class.
Well, yes, if we get a move back above 17,250, which is the recent technical breakdown level, and then, of course, the record highs at around just under 20,000, we could see a lot more blue sky scope for the new year, and a lot of people have been citing that. But potentially that might be less on the Bitcoin proxy and other cryptocurrencies. Either way, I think it's interesting to caution some kind of risk on the, across other markets, because so many people are invested here, so there could be a potential deleveraging situation.
Is Bitcoin different because of the lack of regulation, the lack of clarity, the lack of understanding about how many Bitcoins can be out there as well, the lack of tradability? I just wonder if this one, obviously I'm loath to say it's different this time, but it seems different to literally every other asset class that you look at.
Well, I think this is why the price needs to be separated from the long-term disruption story, just because like all markets and like all bubbles, tulips included, what goes up in a straight line tends to reverse at some point, if not at least in the short term. I mean, some people will be potentially seeing this as a potential buying opportunity for the new year ahead, but either way, always good to be risk averse.